Item 11A is, this is the progress items. We discussed them in committee and moved them here for a final vote without committee vote. 11A is revisions to the Hennepin County Diversity Policy and Hennepin County Non-Discrimination and Respectful Workplace Policy dated August 2012. I know we've had some revisions. I believe Mr. Johnson sent up some revised language also this morning. What would we like to move?
Mr. Chair.
Commissioner Dorf.
I'll move what I assume is the R1. Is it an R1? What are we calling it?
It's still the same resolution since the policies are attached to the resolution, but it would be the revised resolution.
Okay.
There's both the revised diversity, which includes some strengthening of the business case, and then some change in the non-discrimination policy, more succinct bullying policy.
I will move those revisions.
Okay. Is there a second to that?
I will second that.
Second. Discussion on that. Mr. Johnson, do you have the revised bullying language? Is that part of that, or are you interpreting it to the shortened version?
It's the shortened version.
It is the shortened version? Okay. Is that your intent, Commissioner Dorfman?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Commissioner Callison. Yes, Commissioner Callison.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I have some questions, not going to the merits of this as an issue, but just to make sure that I understand the changes. And actually, it doesn't relate to the diversity policy. It relates to the changes now to what would be the non-discrimination and respectful workplace policy. So as I understand it, the two major changes to that would be to include workplace bullying now as a topic, and then to pull out the diversity issues and put those into a separate policy that accompanies it.
Mr. Chair, Mr. Callison, that is correct.
Okay. So let me, if I may, Mr. Chair,
yes,
just ask
sure.
a couple questions. And as I say, it's really going to make sure that I understand what we're doing, not going to whether or not workplace bullying might exist or whether or not it's something that we want to make sure doesn't happen in Hennepin County. But we're not talking about bullying. We're talking about workplace bullying. So, for example, in the first set of bullets under consistent with mission and vision, we now, and this is the second bullet, we strive to ensure a respectful work environment free of all forms of discrimination, including harassment and bullying. And so in the first place, I assume that's workplace bullying. It's not just bullying, so that should be added. But I've been trying to make sure that harassment, that workplace bullying is separate from harassment, that it relates to discrimination. So that's sort of one set of questions. If you go down under rights and responsibilities, the second paragraph, which says Hennepin County is committed to providing equal employment opportunities, goes on promotion of persons from diverse backgrounds. That sounds like it's really the diversity policy, and maybe it should be moved out of the non-discrimination and respectful workplace, but I'm not sure about that. And then the previous policy in this area really talked about employees, volunteers, it talked about vendors, it talked about, I think, contractors. This looks like it's really been narrowed down to focus on volunteers and employees, which is probably right because those are the people that we really control within our facilities. But I want to make sure that that's also been something that was a deliberate decision and part of the conversation around this. So it's really, I think, those three and maybe the fourth really is the harassment versus bullying, if those are really separate things or how they relate to each other. So those four questions, I guess.
Perhaps I ask Monica Long to start to address those, and okay. I can add on.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair, Commissioners, Commissioner Callison, I'll start with your question around the workplace bullying versus harassment.
Mm-hmm.
We added workplace bullying into our policy, but I really feel like it's an additional piece, but that you can also find the workplace bullying could appear as a form of harassment.
Okay.
So even though they're listed out separately, and that was the harassment language was in our policy already
mm-hmm.
and needs to continue to be in there because we've got some legal harassment that exists that we sometimes get complaints around,
mm-hmm.
You could also find that it would fall under there as well. So it really could kind of be a twofold type of thing.
So somebody who believes they're the victim of bullying would also be the victim of harassment?
Not necessarily.
Okay.
I mean, I think it's a case-by-case situation, but certainly in complaints that okay. I've seen in the past, people will refer to bullying as a form of harassment.
Well, is bullying a form of discrimination? Because this talks about all forms of discrimination, including harassment and bullying.
Well, Commissioner Callison, I think it would depend on what the allegation was that somebody was making related to bullying and discrimination.
Okay.
I mean, I think if somebody said, I think I'm being bullied based on the fact that I'm an African-American female, then it certainly could fall under discrimination. But I think it would depend on what the allegation was.
So do you think these changes will help us create a more respectful workplace, or will it create more confusion around what's discrimination and what's harassment and what's bullying?
I don't think it'll create more, Commissioner Callison, I don't think it'll create more confusion, because part of the process is me actually sitting down with employees and really kind of walking through the policy and walking through their complaint so that they understand what the terms mean, so mm-hmm. what they're alleging, and really clarifying that. So I don't think it'll create more confusion. I think it's another aspect for us that to really be looking at and to be aware of, but I don't think it'll create more confusion for our employees. Okay.
And wherever it says bullying, should it say workplace bullying?
It should, yes. That was a good catch, Commissioner Callison.
And then the paragraph under rights and responsibilities that talks about persons from diverse backgrounds, is that really a non-discrimination issue, or is that a diversity issue? Does this paragraph still belong
here? It still belongs. Commissioner Callison, I believe it still belongs here because it really talks about equal opportunity, and part of the equal opportunity piece is the diverse backgrounds. So that's part of the reason that piece was left in there.
Okay. And then previously we talked about contractors, vendors. That language is gone. That may not be a bad thing because that may reflect more directly the people that we control, but was that deliberate?
That was deliberate. We obviously still will occasionally get some calls related to vendors, and we certainly do the best that we can to try to mitigate some of that, but yeah, that was deliberate.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Just for context, this policy then, Mr. Johnson, is part of a much bigger administrative manual. This looks on the effective date in history. There was the first one was adopted in 1997 and then revised or replaced or amended, whatever, in 2001 and 2003. And so this one replaces that. Is that correct?
Mr. Chair, that's correct. There is a series of administrative policies, some of which are board adopted, some of which are administrative.
I think that's an important distinction. So we're looking at the one, and we're going to insert. I'm going to take the movers and seconders to ask them if we're going to take as friendly the insertion of the second bullet under values and intent, the insertion of the word workplace in front of bullying in the second bullet.
Mr. Chair, there's another.
Okay, that's right.
Another word that needs to be inserted, and this is on the second page of what I have. That may not be helpful. Under rights and responsibilities, it's the paragraph that's the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th from the bottom before informal resolution process. And the paragraph begins with county managers and supervisors are responsible. Do you see that? It should be in the next line, including harassment. The word and is missing, including harassment and workplace bullying.
Mine says and.
Mine has it.
Does it?
Yep. Here, I can give you one.
Well, mine doesn't. But thank you.
That is not a form.
Are you sure in the right paragraph? All county managers and supervisors are responsible?
Oh, so the third
for investigating?
Paragraph. Third paragraph does not have.
Oh, I see. Okay.
You're correct.
Am I still correct?
You are still
correct. Thank you. Thank you. That was hard work, but I appreciate it.
How could we doubt you?
This two paragraphs start county managers and supervisors.
So the second line begins discrimination, including harassment.
Okay.
And workplace bullying.
And workplace bullying. Okay, yep. Yeah, well, she's always right. Okay. and then so those are two, and then in the last one, the workplace bullying is we've amended that to include just to eliminate the bullet points, which I think a number of us thought were confusing and potentially open to too much interpretation. So there'll be, it's a segment of the policy, it's a section of the policy, but it's one sentence. Any further discussion? Commissioner Johnson.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I just want to, first of all, the slimmed down definition of workplace bullying, I think, is much preferable to what we had before. I think it's still vague, and that does concern me, but it's much better. My biggest concern is in it's really with respect to the same point that Commissioner Callison mentioned, this, that second bullet point where we say Hennepin County will strive to ensure a respectful work environment free of all forms of discrimination, including harassment and bullying. Workplace bullying. Harassment is a form of discrimination under the law. Workplace bullying in many instances isn't. So I do have some concern about listing it that way. You could say that there are going to be times where somebody is being bullied because of their race or their disability, and you could say that's discrimination, but that's discrimination in and of itself. You don't need the bullying language in here at all for that. So that concerns me.
Mr. Chair?
Commissioner Callison.
On that point, could we clarify by saying in that bullet, strive to ensure a respectful work environment free of all forms of discrimination, comma, including harassment, comma, and workplace bullying. So it's clear that harassment is a form of discrimination, if that's what I understand Commissioner Johnson to be saying, and workplace bullying is a separate item but also of concern. Does that fit, Commissioner Johnson?
So you just add a comma after the word harassment?
Correct.
That would help.
You want to move that?
I will move that.
Second.
Second. Discussion on that? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. The lawyers are at work here. Okay.
No extra charge for those services.
Thanks.
Good news.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Johnson.
I don't think this is necessary. I think that everything we're worried about is already covered in the policy. However, with the language as we've revised it, I'll support it because I don't think it really does any damage to the policy. I still have concerns about vagueness, but I will support this today.
Mr. Dorfman.
Mr. Chair, just want to say I think the revisions to the diversity policy, the language changes, it doesn't change really the intent of what we're trying to say. I think the language changes are good and makes it clear, and as Commissioner Callison has suggested, gives it more teeth. I think what's really significant, I know we've had a lot of discussion around bullying, and adding that to the respectful workplace policy, I think what's really more significant is that we're adding a separate diversity policy and making a really clear statement that we want to create a diverse workforce and that this is a good place for all people to work, regardless of the differences they bring to their work. In fact, that we see that as a value. And I agree with taking out some of those examples of bullying at the end. I'm glad we have a definition in there that's brief, and that we take out those examples that I think created confusion. So I think this is good work. I want to thank Monica and the many staff who worked to bring this forward. Thank you.
Any further discussion on the item as amended? Then all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries.